Now that I made some selections to configure my first tag in the tour, I'm going to go ahead and configure the second tag in the tour, PyML float 11, by clicking on it in the lower right corner pane. I will be taken to the options for the next tag. Again, in the first tab, I will see the name, the barcode. Under comment tag, I will leave the space blank so that my comments are saved as annotations to that tag. I will have the same collection schedule as the tour and no operator instructions. Let me see what are the other options available under the other tabs. In the tag entry option, there are two options that I can select. One is a tag entry preformat. What this is going to do is format the numbers that I enter during data collection to a pre-specified format. That format can be 2 digits and 2 decimal places, or four digits and 2 decimal places with a separating comma. The values that I collect will be saved with this format. In my case, I'm going to use 2 digits plus 2 decimal places. In this same tab, we also have a new feature, which is conditional specification for the collection of data. This feature is going to allow me to collect the data based on certain conditions. And I will have to specify the conditions in here in a pre-described syntax. For instance, let's say that I only want to collect the second tag when the first tag is above 50. I could enter if the current value of my first tag, which is PyML float 10, is greater than 50, then we collect now. Otherwise, we skip the collection. The help files contain all of the functions that are supported by my conditional specification syntax. If I open the help files and go to conditional manual data entry, there is a menu for the supported functions, and in here I can see all of the supported functions plus some examples and uses on how to use these functions. I will show you a couple of examples. Once I finish my conditional specification, I can go ahead and move on to other options.